play along with me for a moment and think of a routine task at work that often makes you think, there's got to be a better or faster way to do this, and maybe the computer can handle it for me. Power Automate is a low-code, no-code tool that just might be the perfect solution for your business challenge. If you've not heard of this tool before, don't worry. I'm going to go over some of the basics to help you get started with the tool, and we will build a couple of simple flows together so that you can see how it works. To get started, we are going to review some key terms. Microsoft calls every automation a flow, and moving forward, this is a term you will hear me use often. The first thing a flow needs is a trigger. This tells Power Automate what needs to happen to start a flow. In the example on the screen, the trigger is a timer set for 10 a.m. every Friday. Next, the flow needs an action, which are the steps in the process. In this example, that would be send an email. How do we send the email? That is the connector, which is a way for the applications to talk to Power Automate. In this example, it is Outlook. This is just a basic flow to demonstrate how the pieces work together in Power Automate. Now let's jump into the live demonstration. To find Power Automate, go to office.com. In the upper left-hand corner, you will see the waffle icon, otherwise known as the app launcher. Select Power Automate from the second column. Now we are on the Power Automate homepage. Here you will find some templates to help you quickly get started. You will also see some links to some learning modules that were created by Microsoft. These are free resources to help you become acquainted with the Power Automate tool. One thing to keep in mind is these are generic lessons that may show you access to tools that your company may or may not allow. For example, my organization doesn't allow us to use Twitter. Next, we will look at the templates page. This is where you'll find several pre-built flows that allow you to plug in your information. At the top of the screen, you see several tabs. The default is to all flows. To narrow down the list of templates, you can select another tab, such as top picks. One of the benefits of using templates is the hard work of figuring out all the pieces has already been done for you. All you have to do is plug and play your information. So for example, this template here, you would plug in your SharePoint site address. Later in the video, we will walk through an example of how to use a template to create your very first flow. The next item we will look at in the navigation menu is Create. On this page, this is where you can see the various ways that you can start your flows. At the very top, we have Start from Blank. The three most common choices that people will use is Automated Cloud Flow, Instant Cloud Flow, or Scheduled Cloud Flow. Desktop Flow and Process Advisor are premium features, and your organization may or may not have paid for those. Let's focus on the three types of flows that everyone has access to. An automated cloud flow is triggered by a designated event. This is just Microsoft's way of saying tell Power Automate what to do if a specific thing happens, such as when an email has an attachment. Email with an attachment is the designated event. Instant cloud flow is triggered manually as needed. This type of flow lets you tie it to a button and it will only run when someone clicks the button. A scheduled cloud flow lets you choose how often it runs. This flow will run at a specified time. In the example I gave earlier about sending a reminder email every Friday at 10 a.m., that was a scheduled cloud flow. Another way to create a flow is to start from a connector. Although there are more connectors than you see on this list, the first few are commonly used, such as SharePoint or Forms. So for example, if you were to click on SharePoint, it would take you to the connector section of the navigation menu, and it would show a list of triggers that you can use to get started, as well as some templates that use SharePoint. I'm going to click on connectors in the left-hand navigation menu so that we can look at a larger list. All of the connectors I'm showing on the screen right now are standard connections. These options are included with a basic Power Automate license. If you go to the drop-down next to the search bar, you can switch over to premium connectors. These options are not included in the standard Power Automate license and would require you to purchase an upgraded license before they can be used. I would be remiss here if I did not give a warning. Some of these connectors will allow for a 30-day free trial, but after that, you must pay to use the connector or the flow will stop working. Let's go back to standard connectors.
Selecting any one will show you the same information as we saw in SharePoint a moment ago. It will show you what possible triggers there are, as well as a list of templates. The next item on the navigation menu I want to briefly discuss is data. Click the drop-down, and I want to focus on connections. As a security measure, some organizations require that their employees re-authenticate their connection to Power Automate on a regular schedule. If it seems like your flow just randomly stopped working, come to the data connection page and see if any of the statuses say fix connection. If so, just re-authenticate and your flow should start working again. The last thing I want to point out in the navigation is My Flows. When you click on this, you will see flows that you have created under the Cloud Flows tab, or flows that have been shared with you or that you have shared with others under the Shared with Me tab. On the Cloud Flows tab, you can see I have a few examples here. If I hover over one and click on the three dots for more commands, I can see several options such as to edit, save a copy, turn off the flow, or delete the flow. One thing that I need to point out to you here is that if you delete a flow, it will permanently be gone and even your admin cannot get it back. If you are in doubt about whether or not a flow is needed, turn it off instead of deleting it. Now it's time to take everything we've just learned about Power Automate and create our first flow using a template. To keep this demonstration simple, I will use the template Save Office 365 Email Attachments to OneDrive for Business. I'm choosing this version of the template because most people who use this flow are using their work account. If it says Office 365 and OneDrive for Business, this is a work account. If it says office.com, that would be a personal account. Click on the template and this will take you to a page that will give you a quick description of what the flow will do and show you what connectors will be used. In this case, it's going to be Office 365 Outlook and OneDrive for Business. Notice that the connections say they are trying to use my work email address, and there's a green check mark indicating that my account has authenticated as a valid user. When you set up a template that uses connections for the first time, you may be prompted to authenticate. This is expected behavior. Click on Create the Flow, and in the background, Power Automate will create a folder in your OneDrive called Email Attachments from Flow. There's no additional action that you need to take. The next time you receive an email with an attachment, the flow will kick off and automatically send a copy of the attachment to your OneDrive. Here's another tip. If someone is using a graphic in their signature block, Outlook is going to read that as an attachment and send it to your OneDrive. I occasionally go in and clean up that folder and delete those images. When Power Automate was done setting up the template, it took us to a details page for this flow where you can change the name of the flow, edit it, turn it on or off, delete it, or see the run history. So far, this flow has no run history because we just created it, but as soon as I receive an email with an attachment, you will start seeing the run history populate in this box. Now let's look at creating a flow from scratch and navigate back to the Create section in the left-hand navigation menu. For this sample flow, I want to post a message in a Teams channel each time an item is added to a specific SharePoint list. This will be an automated cloud flow. When I click on that option, a floating dialog box will appear where I will build my cloud flow. The first thing you're going to want to do is give it a name. If you don't, Power Automate is going to assign a generic one. Then you want to choose the trigger. This is the designated event that will cause the flow to run. In this example, I want when an item is created, which is the second one on the list. You want item, not file, because we're dealing with SharePoint lists here. Now click on Create. There is a card at the top of the flow for when an item is created. Now we must tell Power Automate which SharePoint site to pay attention to by using the site address fields. You will see a list of SharePoint sites that you have access to. For this demonstration, I put the list in the Power Automate Demo SharePoint site. Now that we have specified the SharePoint site, we need to choose the list that Power Automate will pay attention to. In this case, there's only one, Power Automate for Beginners Demo. Next, we need to tell Power Automate what to do when the item is added to the Power Automate Demos list. Click on New Step to choose an action. In this example, we want to post a message in a Teams channel, so the action will be found under the Teams connector. Now we only see Teams actions, and I can scroll through and find the one I want, which is post a message in a chat or channel. The default is to post as Flowbot, and what that means is that when the message shows up in Teams, it will have the Power Automate symbol next to it, letting the reader know that it came from a flow. The other common option is to post as a user, and what this will do is put the name of the flow owner, in this case me, next to the message in Teams. I point this out because not every organization has Flowbot, but my demo environment does, so I'm going to use the default. And then I'm going to choose where do I want it to post, a channel or a group chat. I'm going to post this in a channel for all of my team members to see. Now Power Automate is asking me, okay, what team do you want it in? I will click the dropdown and choose my Power Automate Demos team. Now that Power Automate knows that, it says, okay, well, which channel do you want? I only have a general channel for this team, so that's the one I'm going to choose. Next, you have to put in a message. Notice that when I click in the message area, this box pops out to the right-hand side, and what this is dynamic content. This is going to allow me to choose information from the SharePoint list so that each time there's a new post, it will update to include the most recent information. If you type a static message in the box, then the message will be the same every time. I typically use a combination of both so that I can have a custom message each time my flow runs. You can put as much or as little information in your message as you need. As a quick review, what we've created is a flow that says when an item is submitted to our SharePoint list, post a message in Teams, and let everybody know that a new webinar idea has been submitted. This looks pretty good to me, so I'm going to go ahead and save it. Now, as I always say, you should test every flow that you create just to make sure that the outcome is exactly what you intended. We're going to go to the upper right-hand corner where you will find the test button. The first time you test a flow, you must do it manually since there are no automatic triggers to look for. Then click test at the bottom right-hand corner. Now I'm going to switch to Teams where I have my SharePoint list and quickly enter a new item and suggest a Power Apps webinar where somebody needs to tell me the basics of creating a Power App. Once I save this entry, I'm going to navigate back to Power Automate and you can see that the flow is running and these little green check marks are telling us that everything ran successfully. So now what I'm going to do is go back to the flow itself, and you can see in the 28-day run history, we now have an item, and it also shows that it was successful. And just to close the loop, I'm going to go back to Teams, go to the Post tab, and here you see that Power Automate has posted our message as intended. Both of these flows have been fairly simple just to get you started, but if you want to learn more about Power Automate, check out the video on the screen now, and I'll see you in the next video.